What's up, guys? Leopold the Brave here. Forgive me if my nose sounds stuffy or if my voice is very weak because I have a cold. I've been having stomach issues too, but those don't really affect my voice, so they're whatever. Anyways, the subject for today is statements, when you should take them seriously and when you shouldn't. It basically all comes down to facts versus hyperbole. And the biggest thing to watch out for are character statements, as they're the biggest source of hyperbole. Now, there are times where the characters do know what they're talking about, but most of the time they're exaggerating. An example of this hyperbole would be Uka Uka from the Crash Bandicoot games. At a certain point in Crash Bandicoot Warped, Uka Uka will pop up and tell the player to stop collecting crystals or he'll unleash 1,000 years of punishment on you and the entire universe. Not only is this just an empty threat, but several things contradict it. For one, we've never seen Uka Uka display anywhere close to that kind of power. Now, very rarely, it is okay to accept statements like that even though characters haven't shown anywhere near that level of power, because unlike things similar to Dragon Ball, most fictional verses don't have spare universes or planets to blow up. Then there's also the fact that the hero could just defeat them before they get the chance to use that power. But there's another contradiction in Uka Uka's statement. In Crash Bandicoot 2, the power crystals were stated to have planetary level power. So why on earth would Uka Uka need that planetary power if he could control the entire universe? Yeah, that's what I thought. Yep, character statements are full of hyperbole, but not all of them. So instead of disregarding them entirely, take a look into them. Is it an empty threat? Is a character reading it off of something? Do they know what they're talking about? It's all in the context, just like with lore statements. Now, when it comes to lore statements, the first thing you must check is where you're getting the information from. Are you getting it from a wiki? Is it in the game manual? Is it in-game text? In my opinion, the least trustworthy source, or the one to look out for the most, are guidebooks and data books. Because, more often than not, they are unofficial guidebooks that had nothing to do with the original writers or author. I mean, there's a Naruto guidebook that labels Temari as universal. You know, the fangirl that hangs out with Gaara. Yeah, she's totally universal because a guidebook said so. Then there's also the possibility of mistranslation. Take the whole Boros' star level incident with the One Punch Man guidebook. The kanji for star and planet are both Hoshi, so of course the wankers decide to take the high road to say Boros' star level, even though Boros was aiming his beam at the planet and said he was going to wipe the surface of the planet. I mean, even the English translations of the manga and anime can't decide what Hoshi means. Sometimes it's planet buster roar cannon or collapsing star roaring cannon. So again, guidebooks are a bit iffy. What you want to look for are lore statements within the actual product, but just like with character statements, you gotta watch out for context, as there is some hyperbole there. Let's say a character has a wind-based attack, and an official description of that attack in the product says that it can blow opponents away like a hurricane. You gotta pay attention. Did they say with the force of a hurricane, or like a hurricane? There's a difference there in which it has the power of a hurricane or the effect of a hurricane. Because hurricanes can reach up to city levels of power, and it'd be pretty silly if a small wind attack measured up to that. Another thing you need to look out for with these statements is, are they consistent? Is it a one-off claim to make you go, whoa, nice, or a plot element that you need to be reminded of? If it's a plot element, then yeah, you should probably accept that, because that usually means it's true. Tekken would be a good example of this. All throughout Tekken 6, it was stated that Azazel could destroy the planet. Characters stated it, the lore stated it, there was an entire prophecy about it. Pretty hard to be hyperbole when everything in the plot happens because of it. And as if that wasn't enough, that statement was brought up in the next game when recapping the story. So overall, it honestly really doesn't matter where you get the statement from. From the plot, from the characters, from an official description in the product. It all depends on the context. Is it exaggeration? Is it consistent? Or is it even just an adjective for description? Just avoid guidebooks at all costs.